Welcome to another tutorial of a video series on genome-wide analysis.
In this video, we will be creating our second figure, which is domain architecture analysis. So in this video, we will be able at the end to create our figures using TB tool in the form of this. And we will be using DOG software to create a more beautiful figure using manual domain architecture analysis. So let's begin. So as you know, in our previous video, we have actually already created the gene structure analysis, which was this. So this was actually the gene structure analysis. So now we will be moving toward domain architecture analysis. So let me create one additional folder for this, which will be our figure 2, which is domain architecture analysis. So which file we will be using for this? So we will be actually using this file, where, as you know, in the previous video we have begun for two examples. One was from Arabidopsis and one was from Oryza sativa. So actually you will be using this file. So here you can see in this file, we have already deleted the repeated sequences and we have renamed them according to the sequence. If you don't know how to rename them, so maybe you can watch the previous video before this. So we will be using this file to create the domain architecture analysis. So first of all, what we have to do, we need to go to Google. So actually we need to write CDD NCBI. So that stands for actually conserved domain database on NCBI. So we will simply click on this. So here you can see it is showing the NCBI conserved domain search. So you can simply open this and here you can paste your protein sequences for which you want to find conserved domain. So as you know, we want to find for Arabidopsis genome, which we have already created in our previous file. So we can simply copy this and we can paste it here. So now it's time to begin to choose search against database. So here are the different database among CCD, CDD, that is conserved domain database. You can also use NCBI curated database. But as you know, in the previous videos, I have already taken the domains from the PFAM database. So we will be using this PFAM database. So we can also choose the result mode, although we can choose the full one, but it will create too many results. So I will be going with the standard one. The rest of these criteria you can leave as such, and you can simply just click on this submit button. So as you know, it is running our search, so it will be taking just a few seconds. As here you can see, our results has started to appear and you can see we have actually chosen the data mode standard and we are choosing domain hits. So what we need, we need to simply download this hits data. So we can simply click on this download. So you will see it will start to download this file and it may take again few seconds. Yeah, that's it. Here you can see now it has downloaded this hit data. So we can go into this folder. We can simply cut this file and take to our folder of figure 2, for which we will create this domain architecture analysis. So we can go to this figure domain analysis and this is that file which we have just downloaded. And make sure, because we have used this file, as you know that we have used this file, so we can also save this file into our figure number 2 folder. So we will be using actually these two files to create domain architecture analysis using this DB tool. So once you have these two files, you can simply go to this DB tool. We can go to this DB tool. Let me make it a bit shorter. Simply you can go to graphics, you can go to biosequence illustrator. So among this you can see one option that is visualize domain pattern from NCBI CDD database. So you can simply click on this. So here are the two files which we have just downloaded. So the first one is set up the NCBI CDD table. So this is the NCBI table. We can simply drag and drop and we can close this. You can see this has been selected, and from here that is the setup input FASTA file. So this we can simply take it here and we can close. Now you can see both of our input paths have been selected. So you can simply click on this start button. So here you can see this has generated our domain architecture analysis. So what we can do, we can simply save this graph in the form of PDF to our folder. We can go to desktop and here is remote domain video and this is figure number 2 and here is domain architecture analysis using DB tool. So our image is saved, so we can go to this folder again. So here you can see our domain architecture analysis is ready. So we can also directly use this figure in our research article as figure number 2, but it would be even more better if you can see here ATBR17, ATBR16, ATBR2. This numbering is not in the sequence. And if you have often seen in many research articles, this figure is even more beautiful when they have drawn using PowerPoint or this software. So let me introduce you to one software, that is this DOG 2.0. so how you can download this software? So you can simply download this software using this website dog.biocuckoo.org, or you can simply write this DOG domain architecture analysis tool. So it will take you to this website, and this software is totally free. This software is totally free and it is freely available for academic research. And here in this option you can simply see the Windows platform, and you can download this and install into your computer. Here I have already installed. So we will be using this software to draw its domain architecture analysis manually. Although till here our analysis is already finished, but just for this sake to make our figure beautiful, so we can use this software. So first we will be creating from the ATBAR1. So if you can see that actually the ATBAR1 has two domains. So what we can do, we can simply take this example and we can go to Google. We can simply open Google. We can write here ProCite Expressi tool. So here is ProCite Expressi tool. You can simply click on this. So here you can see in order to get the proteins domains information, so we can paste here up to 10 sequences. So we will be using this file and we will only first paste 10 sequences like this. We can simply copy here and we can paste here, and we can just simply click on this scan. Yeah, here you can see it has scanned our results. So this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Yeah, but this is the first one, that is ATBR. So if you can see, the ATBR1 is actually 1,200 amino acids. So what we can do, we can start with our first protein, that is actually 1210. So this is our first protein. So here you can see we can move this, but we cannot move it to this side or this side. For this, maybe we can click on this edit button, and here you can see it is showing the locked. So we can unlock it and we can now move it freely. So for this, maybe we can save it here. And so now we will be just duplicating this path. So this, we can simply click on this duplicate. So this can be our the first path. So, and we also need to write one name. So we can go to the add, and we can write here the note one. So this is our first one. So it would be ATBR1. So here you can see this is the ATBR1. So you can double click it and you can move it to this side, because as it would be our first. So although we can use this one, and we can duplicate this one to for our later use, because this we can use our later purpose, and we will be just only copy pasting this one. And now this is our first one. So if you can see in the good photographs, we don't need to mention actually this one. So we can go to this edit button. You can see this one is showing on the downside. We can just simply hide this on the both side. You can see it has been hidden. So what we can, we actually can duplicate this. So it is, we can delete this path, and this is ATBR2. And we can again make a duplicate. This would be the ATBR3. We can make duplicate. This would be the ATBR4 and 5. And this would be the 6th one. Yeah, that's it. So as you can see in the first one, is actually the two domains. The first one is from 900 to 980 is actually bromo domain. So we can go to this first one, we can add, and we can add domain from where it's 918 to 980. So it would be 918 to 980. And which color is actually this one? So if you can see, this is actually the green one. So we can make a green color. We can choose this color simply like this one, and we can also hide this. We don't need to mention, and even we don't need to mention the name here. So we can simply hide this. So as you can see, this is will be our first domain on this. And here, if you want to add more domains and their architecture analysis, similarly, as here should be the this proteins, domains, legends. So we can simply add one more protein, or we can simply paste this. We can duplicate this. We can edit this, and this is 12,000. So we can make it like only 1 to 60. Yeah, and we can move it freely. So this would be the our first domain. So we can edit this, we can go this, we can write to the note. This would be the bromo domain. Bromo domain. We can reduce its size as well. We can make 20. So here you can see we can delete this part and we can write this one. And we can mention this one as our green color. We can add it. We can make it green because this would be our first one. So now we can go to this path. We can edit this. This would be the ATBR2. And if we can go to back to our data, so this would be the ATBR2, and ATBR2 actually is the bromo domain, and this total size is 706 amino acids. So we can simply edit this. So it would be 766 amino acids. That's it. And we are going to add one domain that is from 433 to 505. So we are going to add a domain that is 433 to 505, and that would be in the green color. So it would be the bromo domain. We can again hide this and hide this. That's it. And similarly, you can also add other domains. If you can see in this one, it's bromo domain, bromo domain superfamily, ubiquitin. So similarly, we can just duplicate. We can change its color. The next color should be the yellow one. Yeah, we can again duplicate, and its color should be this one. Yeah, we can choose according to our choice and make it while seeing this part. So this would be again this part, and now we can actually change its color to red one. Yeah, so this is actually the bromo domain and this is ubiquitin domain. So we can write it ubiquitin. Yeah, that's it. In this way, hopefully now you understand, and hopefully in this way now you will be understanding that how you can complete this, and finally how you can save this project. We can save this project here in our desktop to this folder, and yeah, here is one video. We can save this if you want to make changes later on. So we can name this as domain here, and if you want to export this as a figure, so you can go to this export option. You can uncheck this keep width ratio and you can select 300 dpi and you can write as domain figure 2. Yeah, we can select its path where to move. Yeah, it should okay here. So we can simply export this one. So we can go back to our folder. This is figure 2, and here you can see our figure is ready, and we can use this directly in our research article. So hopefully now you got an idea that how we can create our figure 2, but make sure you should have a good hand, as you cannot undo changes. And you can play with this software to get good hands on its using. So hopefully now you will be able to create your figure 2. So if you have still any question in the use of this software or in the creation of domain architecture analysis, please let me know in the comment section. Thank you for watching. Bye bye.